First of all, very good morning to all of you. In this class, I am going to start with the new chapter, Biotechnology Principle and Processes. In this chapter, we are going to discuss about the process of biotechnology and their products, and how we can use the biotechnological products for making our desired products. So simply, the chapter deals with the use of technology in the field of biology to produce different type of products with the help of living organism or enzyme. Simply, this chapter deals with the or biotechnology deals with the use of living organism enzyme for the formation of human products. For example, in vitro fertilization, where the test tube baby, the process is test tube baby, and we generally use the bio principle of biotechnology and the processes of biotechnology to form a baby in case of infertile or less fertile couples. So, because of the use of biotechnology simply. So the biotechnology term coined by first biotechnology term coined by term coined by Carl Ereki in 1919. So he was the first scientist who used the term or coined the term biotechnology, or simply the biotechnology deals with the use of living organism biotechnology. Biotechnology deals with the use of living organism and enzymes to produce human products. So the chapter deal with the use of living organism and enzyme to produce human products or the what the human desired. For example is in vitro fertilization. Simply, in vitro fertilization is the test tube baby. So overall, the chapter deal with the biotechnology, tools of biotechnology, and the products by which through the biotechnology we can obtain the different kinds of products. For example, other than the in vitro fertilization or in the formation of the test tube baby production, formation of the test tube baby. Except these, some of the other products we generally use through the biotechnology, like insulin. Insulin or hormone is also formed with the help of biotechnology, or the insulin hormone, which are generally present in markets or formed by the pharmaceutical companies. Simply, they use or through the biotechnology by bacteria, they synthesize human insulin hormone. So that insulin which are generally present in the market, that is exactly the human insulin, but they are obtained by the E. coli bacteria through the biotechnology. So there is so many enzymes which are synthesized generally by that are human protein, human enzyme, human hormones, for example, but the hormone not produced by human or extracted by human, these are synthesized in large scale in bioreactors with the use of biotechnology. So what is the whole process, how we generally, what is the method of biotechnology? In the process, first we summarize a whole biotechnological process, then we discuss one by one in easy way, so that we can easily understand the whole process of biotechnology. In the biotechnology, first we want to prepare or synthesize human genome. So first we if we want to synthesize human protein or human insulin, human hormone, so first we recognize or identify the sequence. That sequence actually code for the human insulin. So first we isolate the gene of human, of any cell. So before the isolation, first we recognize the particular gene is responsible for the synthesis of insulin hormone, for the synthesis of our desired hormone. Then we isolate that sequence, then undergoes in cloning of that sequence. After cloning or amplification of these sequence, then introduction, after the amplification of these sequence, introduction of these sequence into the bacterial cell or Escherichia coli, with the help we are generally culturing the Escherichia coli also. Then introduce into the Escherichia coli, then after from the Escherichia coli we isolate that desired gene, then protein synthesis takes place in the bioreactor. So protein, large scale of protein gets synthesized, because hormone is also formed by the protein, so that's why it is called the protein. Overall this is known as protein. So synthesized by bioreactor, and then after commercialize the protein in large scale, commercialize or transfer the product in other countries or in other cities of India or states of India. So first we discuss about the whole process, then we discuss about the, because this is the process. First we discuss the whole process, then one by one we discuss in detail the steps of biotechnology. So let us start with the first step. In the biotechnology, genetic engineering involved formation of GMO, genetically modified organism. So main goal of biotechnology for the formation of first genetically modified organism. In case of BT cotton is genetically modified organism plant, because the cotton plant, which is a wild type cotton, actually do not form any toxins, or they are not able to save or protect themselves by the different corn borer or lepidopterans, or mostly lepidopterans. So those cause disease on the cotton plant. So through the biotechnology we form the genetically modified plant, that is the plant is BT. For example, the plant is BT cotton. Now, BT is Bacillus thuringiensis because how we made the cotton plant to become genetically modified or introduce what the gene introduced in that plant is gene of Bacillus thuringiensis. Bacillus thuringiensis is a bacteria which synthesize, as we discussed in previous class, in case of in the chapter of microbes in human welfare, where we discuss about the Bacillus thuringiensis. The bacteria are able to synthesize protein or toxins that converted into the toxin. Now, these toxins form porphyration in the lumen of the caterpillar larva. So, larva, all the fluid present in the gut or lumen of the larva exited from the lumen, or so the caterpillar become died after the introduction of toxin by the Bacillus thuringiensis, or production of toxin by the Bacillus thuringiensis. Simply, in the first step, first we want to make a genetically modified organism through the biotechnology. So first, which plant we want to modify, or what the content we want to isolate in case of insulin hormone, or what the protein or hormones we want to isolate from genes isolate from the insulin from the human, so that we make insulin hormone outside from the body of the human. Now, in the first step is identification of desired gene genes. So, simply identification of desired gene is that if we want, here is any cell of the for example, here is the cell of human cell. Now, in human cell, here is a genetic material inside the nucleus. Now, genetic material have the genes for insulin hormone. Now, insulin hormone. So, first we identify the hormone that on the genetic material DNA, on the strand of DNA, which sequence actually codes the insulin hormone, so that after identification we can isolate the desired gene from the DNA. Desired identification. Then second is separation. After identification, first we involve isolation of desired genetic material. Isolation of desired genetic. Isolation of desired genetic material. Now, after the isolation of desired genetic material, then we undergoes in the fragmentation of the genetic material. Third step is fragmentation of genetic material. First is fragmentation of genetic material. That means, we identified that particular how many genes are present on DNA molecule, then which gene synthesizes insulin hormone. First we identified that Then after isolation of desired genetic material, this is the desired genetic material DNA. So we want to isolate this genetic material from the cell. So we need to treat this cell with different kind of enzymes so that the DNA or genetic material we can easily obtain from this cell. After the DNA is available now for the biotechnology follow-up process then after fragmentation of genetic material, this is the genetic material now. Whole genetic material is not required for the synthesis of single hormone or single protein because so many genes are present on this chromosome or that are responsible for the so many types of protein. But there is no need for synthesize all type of protein for which their gene present on the DNA molecule. So that is not needed for the synthesis of only single hormone or single insulin hormone. For example, insulin hormone present is only in that region. So because we have already identified that where the gene is located on the DNA molecule, then after isolation then fragmentation. In the fragmentation process, we use generally restriction endonuclease enzyme. So restriction endonuclease enzyme cut the inner strand of DNA at a specific site. The restriction endonucleases are so specific, so they do not cut DNA at anywhere of the DNA strand. They only cut the DNA molecule at the specific sequence at a specific region. For example, or they are specific to restriction endonuclease enzyme are specific to. For example, EcoR first is a restriction endonuclease enzyme which cut DNA simply break down the phosphodiester bond present in between the guanine and the adenosine. Guanine or adenosine simply. So when we use restriction endonuclease EcoR first, they cut only G or A, the bond, phosphodiester bond present in between the G and A only. So if the G after G is present or G phosphodiester bond present in between the G and T, so they do not cut the bond in between the G and T. They cut the bond or break the bond in between the G and A. So they are so specific. So we only get the specific sequence of fragments of DNA. So fragmentation of genetic material need where whole the DNA undergoes in fragmentation. Then after fourth step is after fragmentation. The fourth step is separation of the DNA fragment. Separation of DNA fragment. Separation of DNA fragment. So, separation of DNA fragments simply single-stranded DNA, separation of single-stranded DNA only. So not the double-stranded DNA, only single-stranded DNA, they separate the, here is double-stranded DNA, all are break by, with the use of restriction endonuclease enzyme, or they get separated, these fragments which are obtained by the use of restriction endonuclease get separated with the gel. The use of restriction endonuclease get separated with the gel electrophoresis process. So gel electrophoresis involves simply a density gradient process where the DNA fragments get separated according to their molecular weight. So they get separated with according to their molecular weight. Or gel electrophoresis use the agarose gel filter, agarose gel, or that agarose gel connected with the anode, because the DNA are negatively charged molecule due to the presence of phosphate group over it inside it. Also, or the phosphate group have negative charges over it, so the positive negative interaction occur, the DNA is negatively charged, and when we connect the agarose gel to the anode, so they are positively charged and positive negative interaction occur, so they move according to their molecular weight. So at on the agarose gel we obtain the DNA fragments according to their molecular weight. After the separation of DNA fragment, then ligation of desired genetic fragment or DNA fragment into vector plasmid. Ligation of desired ligation of genetic material, genetic material or DNA fragment into vector plasmid. DNA fragment. Fragment into vector plasmid. Vector plasmid. So the desired DNA which we isolate from the from the whole DNA sequence. Now the identified that DNA fragment, then isolate into the vector plasmid. Now vector plasmid are simply a plasmid which we obtain from the because as discussed previously in 1972, because some scientists working on the Salmonella typhimurium, or the Salmonella typhimurium are actually antibiotic resistance, or they have antibiotic resistance plasmid or Salmonella typhimurium. Or then when they isolate that plasmid or introduce into the E. coli also become antibiotic resistance. So because they can synthesize E. coli are also synthesize the antibodies or the protein which are resistant to the particular antibiotics. So that is important. Now the ligation, after the ligation of DNA fragment into the plasmid, now plasmid is introduced into the E. coli cell, host cell. Introduction of or insertion of DNA fragment into the host cell. Host cell that is E. coli. Now, after the insertion of E. coli fragment into the E. coli cells, E. coli bacteria. Now, E. coli bacteria are able to synthesize Then after maintenance of E. coli bacteria occur for the maintenance of desired gene, so that we can obtain the desired product. So desired product is what? The insulin, for example, the insulin hormone. So in the host DNA, what we introduce, for example, the insulin hormone formed by the two chain A and B, chain A and chain B is connected by chain C. So there is isolation or the separation of chain C, because chain C present only in pro hormone when the hormone is inactive. When the hormone become activated, so the C chain cut out from the protein, so the protein get converted into the hormone, inactive hormone, or they are functional. Because we cannot introduce whole gene of insulin, because whole gene of insulin also contain C chain. But in our body or inside our cell, there is a mechanism of shorting of the protein which takes place in the Golgi body. So in the shorting of protein which takes place in Golgi body, the C peptide actually gets separated, or the cutting out of C peptide from the pro hormone, so that the hormone is converted into the active hormone, takes place in the Golgi body of the B cell. But if we want to produce the whole protein, whole insulin hormone, so there is no such phenomena takes place inside the E. coli. There is no such function like shorting of protein. So we generally introduce the two gene sequence, that is gene for A peptide and gene for B peptide, undergoes in a separate formation. What is the meaning of that? That is, one set of E. coli synthesized protein A peptide chain, and the second set of E. coli synthesized chain B protein, or peptide B chain. Both are synthesized in separate bacteria, chain A and B. Then after isolation, simply the isolation involves similar to the with the treatment with the human cell also. So then after again the isolation involved, the both the protein chain connected with the help of disulfide base, because originally they are also connected with the disulfide base or disulfide bond in our cell. So overall, this is the process which takes place in the field of biotechnology. The whole process is so complex, so many proteins or enzyme takes place in the process of biotechnology. In next class, we will discuss about the first step, or what are the tools for the first step, what is palindromic sequence, why we need palindromic sequence for the ligation of DNA into the vector, how we obtain the vector from Shishia, from the Salmonella typhimurium. So overall, all this process takes place in the highly sequential manner, highly sequential or as well as highly protected manner, because so many microorganisms are present in our surrounding. So both the biotechnology process, whole the mechanism takes place in very high secure manner, so that we can obtain our truly desired product as like like insulin. So here is the overall about the biotechnology principles and biotechnological processes. In next class we will discuss each one of them in detail. So I hope you like this video. Keep listening and watching me, and thank you for listening and watching me.